If somebody were to ask you, do you know how to pray? Would you know how to answer that? I think learning to pray has to come from a very young age, and I was fortunate enough because our father, he taught all of us kids at the right age how to connect with spirituality, how to stand in front of an idol, how to clasp your hands with respect, connect, and just pray. Pray for your sins. Pray for forgiveness. Pray for salvation. Pray for redemption. One of the things that I didn't do, because at the time that I was growing up, atheism was in a big way. Science was all the power you needed. And so I didn't think it was necessary to teach our children to pray. I look back at it as one of my failings. Here's an example of how to pray. This is Gretchen. We saw her at the water fountain. She now knows for sure that she is pregnant and Faust is missing. And here she is at the feet of the Virgin Mary, Marta Della Rosa. She's praying. I haven't come across much information on Goethe's devotion to the Virgin Mary, but there are clues. We know that Dante Alighieri was a huge disciple of the Virgin Mary, and he used to pray multiple times a day. There are records of the kind of hymns that he did write as well as repeat from history in devotion to her. And Goethe was a great admirer of Dante's work. There's also a few scenes in Faust with reference to Beatrice, who Dante had written these love poems to, called La Vita Nuova. And the same pattern of connectivity does appear in Gretchen with Faust. And so some clues for me personally too. Although I was born a Hindu, the Virgin Mary came to us quite early in life when we moved from rural India to the city in Bangalore. And our home was a couple of blocks away from this huge cathedral. And on the grounds of the cathedral was this grotto of the Mother of God. And all of us as a family visited to pray on countless occasions. And so with that, we now go to the scene. The scene is titled, By the City Wall, Gretchen, putting fresh flowers into the jars. Incline. Thou rich in grief, O shine thy grace upon my wretchedness. Pierce to the heart with thousandfold dart. Thou gazest up to thy dead son's face. To him in the highest thou gazest, sightest, for thine and thy son's distress. Who gauges how rages pain in my marrow and bone? My poor heart's reaching, quaking, beseeching, thou knowest, thou alone. Wherever I go, woe, woe, oh woe, rends my bosom apart. Scarce left alone, I moan, 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 and weep to break my heart. At morn I plucked thee flowers, my bitter tears did rain. Bedewed the shards with showers outside my window pane. When in my room at dawning the sun its brightness shed, I sat in wakeful mourning, already up in bed. Mercy, save me from shame and death. Thou rich in grief, O shine, thy grace upon my wretchedness.